Sean O'Loughlin, and from Samoa, Coach Matty Parrish and Captain David Faalonga. So first question to Steve. This English team, what do you see as the strengths of your side?
I think it's quite recognised that we're pretty strong up front, I think, with the Badges brothers. And you need the microphone.
Yes. I'm going to ask the question again. Cut it from the start. I don't want to be in the footy. Yeah. So, Steve, first question to you. What do you see as the strengths of your English side?
Yeah, I think
Steve, first question to you. What do you see as the strengths of your English side?
Yeah, I think we're pretty strong up front. I think it's well recognised with George and Tom Burgess in particular and James Gray. We're very familiar faces in the NRL. We've got a pretty strong pack, but I think our energy, our youthful energy, coming on tour, coming away to Australia is a great experience for any English touring team, and we're just looking forward to getting it started now, really, tomorrow.
Sean, how's the injury?
It's going all right. This is disappointing not to be involved in this game, just kicking it off, but doing everything I can with the physios to get right, and hopefully have a full week with the boys next week before the Australia game.
Now, are you at risk of losing your job? How's the big fella going to go as captain?
He'll do an awesome job. Jamie's name was probably up there as well as mine when I got the nod. But yeah, Jamie will do what he does, no matter whether he's captain or not. He brings that energy to the side and that enthusiasm which he does every week for his team over here as well.
Now, Matty, the Samoan side are considered the underdogs of this tournament. Is that a positive?
Oh, I think it's just a positive to be, Benny. We don't mind whether we're underdogs, obviously we're not favourites, but we're in the contest, we'll go out there and get 100%.
Dave, how do you and your boys in the middle plan to counter this in-form English pack?
Well, we intend to run the ball hard, obviously, and use our force that we have. Plan to go to the
All right, I'll hand it over to you guys now for any questions from the floor.
Steve, how's pairing? Matty and Gareth, how are they gelling, and is it a bit of a risk just to have a new halves pairing at such a crucial tournament?
I think most of the nations are in that position with players who have withdrawn or not selected from last year's World Cup. I think there's been an evolution amongst most of the squads, but Mike Smith and Gaz Widdop have been outstanding, and we've got two new young hookers in there as well, in Josh Austin and Daryl Clark, so I've got no concerns whatsoever with them. They've looked very comfortable with each other and practice very well.
Do you have some of your players, the Samoan team has changed a fair bit, how
do
some of your players get familiar with the style of the Samoan team and not very familiar, I suppose, playing against
them? Yeah, we're very fortunate that obviously we've got a lot of players who are based in the NRL, so know a lot about the individuals that we're coming up against. Obviously, myself based in the NRL now, I've got great knowledge of them as well. So, look, I know the press are probably the only people who are talking down Samoa as the underdogs. We fully understand the quality of the personnel within their group. We've got some outstanding individual players. Matt is in the same position as myself, trying to get that group of players to play as well as they can collectively on Saturday.
Has that NRL experience for yourself and the players changed the attitude and mindset at all at training? Has it had any impact on the culture?
I think it's been a good mix for our group. I think having six of our group who play in the NRL is a healthy number. I don't think it's too many, and it's not for everybody to play in the NRL. I think that our Super League competition is an outstanding competition. It's well respected across the world. And I think getting the right balance between players playing in the NRL and staying in domestic competition is important for us as an English national team. But I will say that having the benefit of those players and myself here has given us a greater insight into the opposition that we're playing against this year.
And is it just enough for you guys to be making up the numbers?
No, like I said, Denny, I think obviously we're pretty proud of our efforts over the last 12 months. But again, we're in the competition now and we want to compete and... spoke to you on Thursday and the rest of Chris here on Wednesday, sorry. You know, we train really well, but train with a lot of enthusiasm, passion,